masterpiece. Allow God to deal with you how to love and have the anointing in your life. The anointing comes with a price. The only thing that's free is salvation. Everything else you pay for. We want to have the power, but we don't want to pay the price for the power. But it's got to be like Jackie. If they come to your shop, they can't wait to get in their chairs, because when your hands touch their head, that the anointing that flows out of your body begin to soothe that spirit, begin to take away the doubt, begin to take away that spirit of suicide. We can have a nurse practitioner. She works with the doctor, and sometimes she becomes the doctor. But do you realize God just uses plain or ordinary people, plain or ordinary women that will just give him all, no matter how small they are, because little becomes much when you place it in the master's hand. Masterpieces. The master's hand. He is the potter. We are the clay. We gotta relax. God mold me and shape me and how you would want me to be. Because God, even though I got dreams and plans, God, you've got something bigger for me. And God, if I'm going through this, it's preparing me to where I'm going. Why are you always doing this? Why I go through so? Why is it that you want God to give you so much power and anointing? There's a price to be paid. Amen. You look at me. I got all this bat wing dress. But you don't know the story. We all have a story, Mother Bar, in this room. Everybody is not going to escape life. You're going to have to deal with life. Life is what it is. But I feel sorry for you that if you don't take the scriptures and what God said in his word, that though you're slain, yet I will still trust. The word is him talking. Yes. But you know what? We get in church, my baker Annette, that we hear the word, but we don't do nothing about the word. Right. It just sounds like grandma was saying the same word, my mama was saying. The word is the word. It's for us to take the word, to live by the word, that we may be strengthened each and every day, because the enemy, he desires to destroy you. He desires to wipe you to do this, and I dare to be different.
Yes.
I dare to be different.
Yes.
And when I stepped out now, God started letting people donate stuff to me. Let me tell you something. Many of us feel that, oh, we can't do this because we ain't got no money. But when you and God, who told you that you had to have money? I can't go to school. I can't have this job. Who told you that you have to have, that you had to go to this school to get this particular degree in order for God to give you what he wants to give you? I'm telling you, y'all, y'all are sitting in a miracle. When I tell you, every time I turned around, doors were opening. People were giving me, even people at Staples. I don't know if it was my continent, because I tell God, God, wherever I go, God, let favor rest on me. Let favor see. Some of y'all just do it in church. I do it on church wherever I go. So let me tell you something. If you can't take God where you go, then you don't need help.
Come on!
Keep power. You gotta knock that door down. You gotta. toxic, under the Moshanda, women of God. I want to read the scripture real quick, because I want you to say, you know, she was talking and she didn't give us scripture. I know who I'm dealing with. Hallelujah. I want to go to Ephesians. Ephesians 2 and 10. And I'm about to say a little something, and I'm about to sit on down. Bookie, my daughter-in-law all the way from Nigeria, Africa. Ephesians 2 and 10, I want you to read it out of the Amplified Bible. She said her accent, girl, please, man. Ephesians 2 and 10. I want you to take this. Yeah, we're glamorous. We're elegant. And God has made us a masterpiece. But what are you going to do with the masterpiece? Amplify. Yep, Bookie, I want you to read it. Okay? Sweet Jesus, that's it.
Okay. Ephesians 2, verse 10.
That's my text for all of this.
For we are his workmanship.
For we are his
workmanship.
Workmen. That means you gotta do something. Yeah. Yeah. You sit down and say you workmanship, we gonna finish. I have somebody say, you are his workmanship.
His own masterwork.
His own masterwork. Ain't nobody like you. Right. Don't nobody have your fingerprints.
That's right.
You are authentic, original.
Yes. Yes.
He knows the hairs on your head.
Yes.
He knows who you are, little bell.
Oh, yeah.
I don't care how old. I don't care how young. He knows who you are. Read.
A work of art.
A work of art.
Created.
No. A work of art.
Yes.
You gotta be careful with your work of art that you don't get so big and just work of art.
Right.
Turn around and sit back down and you slip. No, you're not. A work of art. Read.
Created in Christ Jesus.
Created. Yes. Debbie, created. Yes. In Christ. Yes. Jesus.
Yes.
You wasn't born. You wasn't a mistake.
Come on.
Yes. You're not an accident. Yes. I don't care how you came here. Yes. Read.
Reborn from above. Spiritually transformed.
Spiritually transformed. We gave some things today spiritually, naturally. Sometimes you'll be surprised. It don't always take spirituality to transform you. It can just take wellness, walking in the park. You know how many times I've walked in the park and God began to talk to me?
Yes.
When I get up early in the morning, when I used to go jogging or just walking, it felt like the birds, I can hear him talking.
Yes.
Read that again.
Reborn from above, spiritually transformed.
Spiritually, a lot of us need to be transformed. Our minds need to be transformed. We have to be transformed by the renewing.
Yes.
Our new mindset. Some of us got a sick thinking.
Yes.
Love yourself.
Yes.
Embrace yourself.
Yes.
Treat yourself.
Yes.
Do go somewhere and get your hair done.
Yes.
Get your feet done. Get your toes done.
Right.
Come on. But you know what we do? We will spend money on sneakers for our kids, and they don't even care. They are just sitting up here. Then you're left at night walking around depressed, no joy, tired, look over. The person that you may be married to don't love you like you love them. Your kids disrespect you. Read that.
transformed.
Spiritually transformed. It's up to you.
Renewed.
Jerry, my sister, it's up to you. It's a choice. I felt it. You know, some things I refuse to be fat anymore. You do something about it. The Bible says faith without works is what? Me preparing all of this here. No money. No budget.
And never give God what he had intended you to do.
Everything went different today. I hear, I smelled the candles. I was going to share my little testimony. Okay, amen. But I went over 2 minutes. Okay, this is my part. I can do what I want. Spring or late spring, and we're going to start early. Do you not know we did this in 2019?